Hello friends, happy Monday, welcome to week 4 of the randomizer. I didn't think it was going to take this long. Honestly, I kind of hope I can wrap it up this week, because I'm itching to move on to something else. I am having fun with this, I'm enjoying it. Maybe it wasn't the best choice to come back after a long hiatus, but I've been playing a lot of it on my own. And I thought, this is kind of what I'm interested in right now. Or was interested in. I'm still interested in it. This is a good run. It's just long. So I don't really have a full plan right now. I have like an index card's worth of notes about locations in Threed. Dead ends I've already explored and a couple important locations. I'm going to try to finish systematically exploring Threed, and if I don't find the path to the boss, I guess I will head back to the Mole Caves, which I can get to by going through the bakery. And I don't know if I have notes for everywhere. Oh, that's an ATM. Everywhere I've already been. 11,000. Nice. Let's get a little bit of cash. I guess 1,000 is more than a little, but I'm not quite so scared about losing it now that I have some better defensive equipment, and I want to have some on hand if I need to revive party members at a hospital or get through one of the museum locations. I haven't checked out the graveyard, and I don't know if I have a reason to. I don't think there's any way to go through it in the randomizer. In Earthbound, one of the gravestones leads to a secret passage. Laser gun. I have no idea how good that is. It is worse than the Crusher Beam. Which makes sense. But if that's an item... Ooh. Ooh, big treasure room. Hi, Sonic. Thank you for the treasure. That's not treasure. That's not treasure. Okay, I take it back. This is the junk room. That's pretty good. Handbag strap. I have no idea what that does. If it does anything. When used as a whip during battle. Oh. It was one of the several stun the enemy for a turn consumable items. I don't need to keep that. No. That present. No. That present. Thank you. Hyper Beam. That sounds pretty good. It's not as good as the Crusher Beam. Crusher Beam is pretty good, it turns out. So who do I want to have that crystal charm? Well, first off, does it have any effects besides defense? Paralysis. Paralysis and speed. Okay. Well, I like Monty with the rabbit's foot. I think I'll give the crystal charm to Mario. Because he just has a plain old travel charm. Tiny bit of defense. And tiny bit of speed, I assume. Okay. That's fair. So, I don't have notes for every building. Because I just kind of skimmed through my previous footage. Oh, sorry. I think this side of Freed in general... I mean, to be fair, I am a zombie. Like, that is a reasonable reaction. So I know I've been in there, that's a dead end. I know I've been in that little greenhouse. I know that tunnel leads to a dead end. Actually, did this lead to a shop? No. Okay. Now that I know the location of an ATM, I might want to try to make my way back to a shop. Maybe. A bunch of... Oh, hi. Question mark. It's one of your friends or relations. The Crusher Beam might be Mario's best weapon. I don't remember it getting much better than that. Ooh, healing gamma. That's good. That's the one that can revive a party member. It costs a lot of magic points, and it doesn't have 100% chance of working, but compared to nothing, I'll take it. I'll take three. Alright, so that tunnel leads back to Summers, which... Yeah, it might be a good idea to revisit Summers just to get that, just to hit the sanctuary and get question marks magic points back. I'm going to mute the mic for a moment because I have to cough. Alright. Apologies. It's a good thing that I had a mute button handy. Otherwise, that could have gotten ugly. I remember that I can set a limiter filter for the game audio in OBS. So hopefully that fixes the problem of the music being wildly imbalanced. The limiter should keep it at about the same level throughout, which is a real handy feature to have. I also forgot about the noise gate filter because it's been a year since I recorded, so the first videos in the series were kind of rough as far as like mouth noises go. And I'm sorry about that. I think I got my recording legs back for the most part. Kinda wish Ness had some more magic points. Oh well. No magic required for that one. Carton of cream. Ooh, Psy Flash Beta. Shield Beta. Good stuff. So enemies in the graveyard will be a different difficulty level than the other enemies in Threed. Oh my god. Because they are set to spawn enemies based on the other side of the secret passage that I can't go through. And someone made an issue about this in the GitHub for the randomizer, and this is an intended feature because graveyards are spooky, and this one is quite spooky. That enemy on the right in particular will explode when it dies, so I want to try really hard to kill it last, which means I have to limit the amount of AoE that I use. Feigned Klaatu. Oh gosh. Well, this was an unwise endeavor. Alright, where was my last save point? Well, there goes like 500 bucks. C'est la vie. Okay. So I can get back to Threed this direction, and then I can I can go through. Oh, this is an arms dealer who sells platinum bands. All right. Yeah, I was excited about the possibility of finding an arms dealer because they sell multi-bottle rockets. But I was forgetting that the items are totally randomized, so they're not actually better or worse than any other item seller. But I might pick up a couple of those platinum bands. Platinum is really good. If a band goes platinum, that means they sold a million records, so pretty good stuff, or successful stuff, which doesn't always equate to good. Thank you, Magic Magnet. Alright, let's go ahead and just withdraw all my money. And avoid the graveyard. I don't think I'll be able to buy 3 platinum bands. Yeah, I almost forgot this question mark was a person. Well, I might be able to buy 3 after I sell some of this junk. No. Oh, old RPG interfaces for buying and selling stuff. Wait a sec. I guess I already had a crystal charm, and I just forgot to give it to Mario. Oh well. keep all that stuff. Sell the deluxe fry pan. Yeah, inventory management and buying and selling and more menuing than is reasonable. definitely the worst thing about old RPGs. I mean, I love them. It's one of my favorite genres. But I'm definitely glad that we have moved past this. Like, if I could just select every item that I want to sell, and like it puts a little star next to it or something, and then it just sells all of it at once. That would be nice. Oh, the laser gun is worth a dollar because that's one of the guns that you get by repairing an item with Mario. And those are all worth a dollar for some reason. Let's see. I think the broken trumpet just turns into another defense shower, which might be worth holding on to. I don't know. Alright, platinum band. Or Ness. 180 to 190. Oh, I can just buy defense sprays. And I forgot about the money I was going to get for selling the gold bracelets. But that's good. I have a decent chunk of money left. Go take care of that. All right. Now, to figure out what the heck I'm actually going to do. I feel like I've explored most of the options in Threed. The graveyard was definitely a bad idea. I wouldn't go back in there if he paid me. I guess Ness's dad would pay me. And I'm still not going back in there. Alright, that's a dead end. The tunnel east of here just goes back to Orange Kid's house. So I think the next move is to go back into the mole caves and figure out if there's a direction there that I haven't been. Well, I guess... Have I been in the hotel? I don't remember the hotel with the... Oh. Hello. Well, there's another ATM. Here's some stuff I don't need. Is that a shopkeeper? No. It's just a normal phone. Well, let's save here. I won't be hitting the hay for the night, though. I just got started. Oh, you're another shopkeeper. More expensive platinum bands. That's probably the one available in Summers. And I don't need any of that other stuff. Sure. Let's see if Mario can repair the other trumpet. Yeah, another defense shower. Which I guess is good. I don't know. It didn't seem to be that much of a boost. It's very situational. Yeah, the Runaway 5. They're a platinum band. Okay, I don't have any notes about the hospital. hospital has a blob and two bugs in front of it. Okay. Sci-fire? Sci-freeze? I do remember the irritable Hurley has a pretty good number of hit points. But I'm doing a good bit of damage. Lethal orb. Okay, so that orb is going to explode. So I will focus fire on the awful buffalo. Ouch. 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 Eh. Question mark has enough hit points to just shrug it off. Well, ice doesn't do much. That sucked. Nope. All right, pizza and drugstore are both dead ends. Let's try the tent again, because I don't remember how many of these alternate paths I have and haven't taken. Oh, well, that's another way to get back to the mole caves. Before I check that out, alright, so that goes back to the tent. This goes back to this room. This is the Dungeon Man dungeon, like the first one that he made when he was still an amateur dungeon designer. Which has a little bit of loot in it. It might have a few enemies in it too. But it's just a beginning dungeon, so shouldn't be too bad. The Mr. Saturn! Boing! It's a Mr. Scorpion! Bash! I'm not drinking any cream that I got from a scorpion. I do not trust it. No offense to any scorpions watching. No, thank you. It's a mouse convention up there. Looks like they're having a good time. It was nice of that fire to just clip through the rocks like that. Well, I can go back and fight the big blob monster if I want to. Spoiler, I don't want to. But I'll hang on to it anyway, as a souvenir. What are you? Oh. Okay. More branching paths. Oh. This is a boss room. Excellent. Let's make sure everyone is as healed up as possible. Who needs healing? Really just question mark. Well, I wasn't expecting to just stumble across the boss like that. Do I actually want to do that? I figure I probably do. Oh, full heal. Nice. This is Dungeon Man. Your homemade dungeon helped me out a lot. Normally, you can go down these holes. They're blocked off in the randomizer. They would just cause too much chaos. Well, a full heal before the boss fight is nice. I'm glad I explored that direction. Alright, well, let's give it a shot. I forget which boss this is. But if I get wiped out, there are many places I can recover. So this is boss number 6. So only 2 more after this. And then Gigas. Alright, this thing is going to do physical attacks. Which makes me think I want to do a shield, a physical shield. Which is a question mark spell. Definitely want to spy on this thing. Canine Guardian. Canine. Gotcha. Now let's use a defense shower. They're only $500. And then Shield Sigma. Oh, this thing is tough. Alright, somewhat vulnerable to fire, not that vulnerable to freeze, 50-50 flash, no paralysis, 50-50 hypnosis, no brain shock, no mirror. Yeah, that's not much of a boost. Oh, yes, please steal Monty's magic points. Do that as much as you want. Alright, well, 50-50 for hypnosis, so I will try that. Freeze doesn't work that well. I will try fire. I will try shooting, and I will try Starstorm? That's a lot of flashing. Yes, steal all of Mario's psi points, please. Oh, I hope it just keeps doing that. If it does, then I'm going to attack. And I'm going to attack. And I'm going to attack. And I'm going to Starstorm. Ooh. Okay. Let's use a psi laser and try to deal some actual damage. Cause just smacking this thing isn't doing that much. Unfortunately, Mario doesn't have a lot else he can do. Oh, that's right, the defense shower is reusable. That's not a consumable. I'll save my bottle rocket. Alright. The Canine Guardian has been defeated. 29,000. Oh, now Ness has Life Up Gamma. That's good. As long as either Ness or Question Mark survive, I have a chance of reviving people. Psy Freeze Omega. Nice. Alright, that is Dungeon 6 done. That is progress. Oh, it's a pretty music. Nice. Well, that seems like a good place to end this one. Thanks for watching. Tune in tomorrow for a new episode of Earthbound Ancient Cave Randomizer. Please enjoy this healing music. Goodbye.